Can you all hear me? No? Oh, look at hi. Good afternoon, everyone. I am Maria Shea, and I'm this year's Oiler Marching Band president. I want to start off by welcoming you all here. We're so glad to see you. I want to welcome all of you who are here, not only in person, because thankfully we can do that again, but also those of you who are also joining us on UFTV. We also want to wish you all a happy Halloween. This is super exciting. And also, welcome Oiler Marching Band. go ahead. Just a few little things that we want to inform you about how this year is going. Our band program is going super strong. We have grown both in size as well as quality during the pandemic. And we also were able to host our first high school band show this year last weekend. So we welcomed multiple high schoolers. Multiple students came and played with us, and hopefully they will be returning in the future as college students. A little bit about the program. We're a super young band this year. Only 15% of our entire band are graduating seniors, with two being continuing on as seniors next year, and only one junior. So we're pretty full of sophomores and freshmen this year. And then some welcoming and introducing some of our staff. Our Oilerette instructor is Miss Tabitha Kirsch. I don't know where she's at. She's hiding over there. And then our color guard instructor is Miss Sydney Clausing, over here in this corner. And then our drumline instructor is Rob Sieslick. I don't know if he's here. Okay. And then our administrative assistant is Miss Cindy Bermuth. Then I'm going to give you a little personal thoughts about how this year has gone personally. If you don't want to listen, tune me out, but that's okay. This year has been great in my opinion. I have never had a band fit so well together. We have become friends, a giant family. Things just went so smoothly, and I hope that we can continue that next year, and I love them all so much, and I hope that our love for each other shows through into our music. I do want to ask that you please silence your cell phones, as we do have our UFTV back there recording for us. And then please help me welcome our director of bands, Dr. Wes King, and we invite you to stand for the playing of our national anthem and alma mater.
Well, good afternoon, everybody. My name is Wes King, and I am the Director of Bands here at the University of Findlay. And it is my distinct pleasure to MC tonight's event, presented by our wonderful and talented students of the Euler Marching Band. The Euler Marching Band is under the student direction of senior Maya Watercutter. And thank you to our band president, Miss Maria Shane, for her introduction this afternoon. So the marching band at the college is in some ways the soul and spirit of the university. And so we want to start today's concert with a little bit of our school spirit songs. So you're going to hear the pregame, the UF pregame fanfare, which is a composition by our former director of bands, Professor Jack Taylor, our University of Findlay fight song, our new first down cheer, our Let's Go Oilers cheer, and the Oilers spell out with the drum line. Here is the University of Findlay school spirit. Good job, everybody. Up next, we're going to play music from our first halftime show. So just to give you a little bit more background information on how we do things, these students come to a summer band camp approximately 10 days or so before the start of school. For some of them, it's closer to 2 weeks if they're in the drum line or leadership or color guard or twirlers. And so these students train approximately 80 instructional hours before freshman welcome week starts. And they have their first two performances, a friends and family show and the arch ceremony, before the first day of classes. So these students are working tremendously long hours in the summer, and then they have their school rehearsals Monday, Wednesdays, and sometimes Fridays as well. And then for our first halftime show, we wanted to do something that was emblematic of the times. And as you all are probably well aware, we did not have a marching season last year. In fact, I don't think a single college band program had a marching season. And most high school band programs were shut down. And so we experienced a year for many of us without sports, but for almost all of us without marching band, or at least bands on the field. And that was a very trying time for many of us. I know for myself, it was the first time in 21 years to not have a summer band camp last year. And those things had ramifications for band programs all over the country, with the lack of training that goes in with band camp and things like that. But our band program did exceptionally well during COVID-19. We were able to still rehearse and perform. And in fact, from last year to this year, unlike many of our peer institutions in the greater region, we grew. And so things are going extremely well. So we wanted to celebrate that fact and celebrate the fact that marching band is back. And so we put together a show of an eclectic mix of music representing the traditional types of marching band shows that many band programs do, such as classic rock, Latin music, Broadway, and pop or movie-influenced music. So you're going to hear the famous, immortally famous song, Immigrant Song, Fireball by the artist Pitbull, Jet Song from the musical West Side Story with music by Leonard Bernstein, and I'm Still Standing, the famous song by Elton John and made popular again by the movie Rocket Man. So join us as we celebrate all these traditional styles of marching band shows with Marching Band Is Back. All right. Thank you so much, man. That was awesome. That first halftime show, we put a lot of time and energy in, and they put a lot of sweat hours into that one. So if you didn't get to see it on the field, you can just imagine how much fun it was for them to perform. One of the things that we also try to do is to have a wide variety of things that we play, both on the field and in the stands. So we try to play different genres and music from different eras, and so we're going to play a hip-hop tune called Shout It Out, and it was made famous by the movie Drumline. So here it is, Shout It Out. Before we play our next number, I just want to tell you a little bit more about the band program here, especially if you're here for one of your students and they're a freshman. Some of the things you may not know is that, for instance, we do not have a music major here at the University of Findlay. So every single student that you see on stage is studying something other than music, and yet they're living proof that you can study animal science or pharmacy or pre-med or English or social work and continue to make music and be in band. And hopefully they are on the path to being lifelong musicians, like many of the talented community musicians we have that play in our symphonic band and the Findlay Civic Concert Band here in town. We're also very proud of the fact that in our band program, many of these students have opportunities to have a student leadership position. So student leaders, would you please stand up and be recognized? Thank you. We believe in the value of servant leadership in our band program. And so these student leaders are planning things before the school year even started, before band camp. They are some of the first to arrive and some of the last to leave. They are the ones helping load things on the U-Haul or the cargo van and unloading things into the storage facility. These leaders have been absolutely outstanding, and they are emblematic of the wonderful and kind and friendly students that we have here at the University of Findlay. And I want to say a special thank you to these leaders, especially for this year. As many of you may be aware, my mother was killed in September, and these student leaders stepped up along with our staff, along with Tabitha and Sydney and Rob, especially, who took over the whole program while I was gone, and Cindy and Valerie as well. And they stepped up, these students in particular, stepped up in a tremendous way, and all of these students really did. And when I came back after being gone for a couple weeks, it was just really, you know, heartwarming and affirming to see that not only were they productive while I was gone, but they were where they needed to be, and they had grown and they had progressed. So I really want to say a thank you to those student leaders and our staff in general for their amazing leadership this year through these very unusual times we went through together. The next thing that we're going to play is a very, very famous tune that is very commonly played by marching bands around the country. You'll recognize it right away, even if you don't know its name. Here is Land of a Thousand Dances. Maria mentioned this earlier when she spoke about this band being a family, and you know, that's something that you hear a lot, but it's something that's very true in this band program. I mentioned how wonderful these students are, and I just want to say a personal thank you to all these students. They are so great when my kids are around, and as they may not agree with their costume judging skills after our first annual Halloween costume contest rehearsal, but they are wonderful, and you know, for those of you who are watching and you may be thinking about coming to Findlay, or if you're here in the audience, you know, parents, I am so comfortable with my small children, you know, fourth grade, second grade, and kindergarten, and soon to be born, being around these students and having some of these students babysit for us. These are just wonderful young people, and they give me tremendous hope for the future. So, you know, students, you're awesome. And in that vein, you know, of having fun and being family, we wanted to do something really fun for being back this year. So we want to play music from our second halftime show for you today. Now, YMCA, we didn't get around to really more than a couple rehearsals, so that was unfortunately left in the program. So we won't be playing that. But the second halftime show is built around dance and Dance With Us. And so we begin with Walk the Moon's Shut Up and Dance, Cupid's famous, I guess you could say maybe one-hit wonder, Cupid Shuffle, and then the music of Bruno Mars, in particular his song Uptown Funk, one of my favorite modern pop tunes in recent years. So if you feel the need or feel the spirit move you, get up and you know, bust a move with us as we play Dance With Us. Thank you. Shout out to my people upstairs dancing. I know, the rest of us are good Northwestern Ohioans and we sit still in our pew at church on Sunday. It's okay. One of the things that I neglected to mention is that all of these students on stage are eligible for band scholarships regardless of major. And we have band scholarships available for all of our ensembles, our marching band, our basketball pep band, our concert bands, and our jazz ensemble. And we invite you to all of those concerts or performances as we go on throughout the year. And in fact, there are dates in your program, I believe, that have some upcoming performances and events. We have a third sort of pseudo halftime show that we're working on, and you can see it at the last home football game in the second week of November. And we will be honoring our armed forces with the Armed Forces Medley, playing all the service songs, and recognizing those in attendance. So if you are currently serving or have served, make sure you come out to that football game so we can honor you in person. We are going to go back and play one of our stand tunes that the students loves to play a lot. The band Queen has, I mean, kind of like an innumerable number of hits that we could go over and we could play. So if we had to choose one, and one that fits us and what we're all about, we're going to play one called Crazy Little Thing Called Love. Here it is. What an appropriate song for our band. We absolutely love what we do, and I love working with these young people. And, we've got students that come from really far away. We've got students that are from here, right in Findlay or in Hancock County, and we've got students who come to us from as far away as New York City and other states. And so we are just so grateful that these students come from all over and share their gifts of music with us. It really just makes my day and makes my week, and I've loved seeing them grow from last year to this year and from the beginning of this year till now. It's hard to believe, isn't it, those of you in the audience, that this band is almost entirely freshmen and sophomores, but they are doing outstanding work, and we are really excited for where we're going in the future. And I also want to commend those of you here in the audience. If you're on the live stream, it may be hard to tell, but we have the twirlers and the color guard who, I'm going to go on a soapbox issue for a sec and chastise some of my colleagues in the field. These young students in these sections are just like any other section in the band. They are 100% part of our band and part of our band family, and I'm so proud of the efforts of these young people out here on the floor. But kudos to you in the front few rows for braving the splash zone, so to speak. So we are so grateful for all of these students. And this is always one of the hardest times of the year. And it'll be like this again in the spring. But unfortunately, we do have seniors in our band this year, and we have some graduating seniors. So graduating seniors, please come to the front and assemble in your alphabetical order like we practice. Before we talk about the seniors, I want to say that we recognize every student for their years of service, and we award them a certificate. But for these seniors, you know, we wanted to give them maybe just a slightly nicer presentation of it. And we also invited each senior to talk about their experience in the band program here. So I'm going to read, and hopefully not have to edit too much, what they say. But let's begin. So our first senior is Caitlin Bidlack. And Caitlin, pull up yours, will be graduating this May. And she will be graduating with a Bachelor of Arts in Social Work. She has been in the marching band here for 4 years. And after her college experience and after she graduates, she plans on pursuing her master's degree in social work at Case Western and joining active service as a military social worker. Her highlights as a UF student include being the vice president of Phi Alpha Honor Society, Eta Theta Chapter, vice president of the Social Work Club, and the student representative for the College of Health Professions on the Alumni Board of Governors. And for highlights for her marching band participation, she says that she's been in marching band her entire time, her 4 years, and one of the highlights being this year, acting as the vice president and being able to serve her fellow students. So thank you, Caitlin, for everything you've done for our band program. No, we'll save that for later. Up next is Michaela Jennings. Michaela will be graduating this May in spring 22, and she will be earning a degree in children's book illustration. She's been in the UF marching band for 4 years, and after college, she hopes to publish her picture book and work on more. She hopes to sell her art at conventions and travel the country while doing it. And most of all, she hopes for many dogs in her future. Highlights as a student, attending studio classes taught by the best professors, and making art with friends that she has known since day one of freshman year, and growing as an artist, as artists together. And her favorite highlights of marching band participation, marching through the tunnel at pregame. Yes, that's awesome. So thank you, Michaela, for your service to the band program for these 4 years. Up next is Miss Chrissy Johnson. It will come as no surprise to the band students that she was the first one to fill out the form. Chrissy is a senior graduating in May, and she will be receiving her Bachelor of Science in Forensic Biology. She's been in the marching band for 4 years, and she plans after college to work in a lab after she graduates. Highlights as a UF student, meeting really awesome professors and friends, and her highlights of a marching band participation. She actually is not a brass player natively. She started as a clarinetist, and when she came here, she wanted to march, and at that point, the marching band only had brass and percussion. So she learned to play a brass instrument after being a woodwind. This year, she has served as my student assistant and done an amazing and fabulous job at that. And she has loved getting to help everybody in the band and meeting her best friends. So thank you so much, Chrissy, for your service to our band program. Thank you. Up next is Miss Lillian Seifker. Lillian will be graduating in the spring with a Bachelor of Science in Computer Science. She's been in the marching band 4 years. She's also one of our students that switched from woodwind to brass for marching band. And after college, she plans on working as a web designer for her internship employer and continuing her small business. Well, that's what we want to hear. Job right out of college. Awesome. Her highlights as a UF student, I got to continue my interest in music with marching band, concert band, pep band, and art with her graphic design minor. And highlights as a marching band student, gaining lifelong friends and made the best memories as well as learning her brass instrument. Thank you so much, Lily, for your 4 years of service to our program. Up next is Mr. Garrett Smith. Garrett is graduating in December, so at the end of this semester in just 5 short weeks, I guess. Garrett will be graduating with a Bachelor of Science in Biology, and this is his 5th year in the University of Findlay Marching Band program. After college, he plans to pursue the physician assistant program here at University of Findlay after a gap period. His highlights as a UF student, current vice president of Theta Chi, involvement in the Wind Ensemble Marching Pep and Jazz Band for the past 4 years, and his highlights as a marching band student. He's really enjoyed and taken pride in his continued growth and proficiency with the trombone. He actually is an alto saxophonist. And an instrument I never would have been able to learn and play if I hadn't gotten the opportunity here. It also meant I got to be a part of the coolest section in the band and make some of my best friends. Thank you, Garrett, for your years of service to our band program. Up next is Miss Maya Watercutter. Maya will be graduating this spring in May with a Bachelor of Science in Biology. She's been in the marching band these past 4 years. After college, she plans to pursue a Master of Physician Assistant Studies at the University of Findlay. And as a highlight as a student, she's enjoyed all the friends she's made as a student of UF. And before I read the next part, I want to recognize Maya in that to the best of my knowledge, the marching band program here has never had a student conductor, and Maya has been our first inaugural conductor for the last 2 years and done a fantastic job. So thank you for creating that position for us and doing it with aplomb. Highlights of her marching band participation. She really enjoyed watching the band program grow over the last 4 years and the people that she's met through the band programs. She also really appreciates all the lessons that she's learned in both conducting and leadership as the band's drum major. Thank you, Maya, for everything that you've done for our program. And last but not least is Mr. Kevin Ewan. Kevin will be graduating slash progressing on to the next step, and you'll understand here in a minute, this May, as he progresses to the grad school program in our 6-year pharmacy program. And Kevin has been in the marching band now for 4 years. And after this year, he, like I said, is intending to continue on in the graduate portion of his program and become Dr. Ewan in hopefully 2 short years. So those of you who are looking to That's right. Welcome to the Doctors Club. It's pretty fun. If those of you looking for a pharmacist in the next couple years, talk to Kevin. His highlights as a UF student, being a low brass section leader and the president-elect of his Honors Pharmacy Society, and his highlights of a marching band participation, all the friends I made like Mackenzie. So there you go. So thank you, Kevin, for all your service and your wonderful leadership this year as the low brass section leader. Thank you. And thank you to all these seniors. While they get seated and before we play our final portion of tonight's concert, I just want to say thank you to some individuals. I want to say a big thank you to UFTV for live streaming this event and all the amazing work they do throughout the year. I hope that they get all the support they need across campus because they are amazing. Thank you to Joe in the back for running our recording and our audio tonight and making this available both for the stream and for recording for some high quality audio tonight. I want to thank Valerie Escobedo, our chair, and the Curtain Raiser Society for ushering and helping out with tonight's event, and all the sponsors in our program. If you can support those sponsors, we would be in your tremendous debt. Thank you so much to the administration and for all of their belief in this program, their support, and the things that they want to see happen. They are following up those wishes with the resources. So we are so grateful to have a supportive administration backing up our band program. Thank you again to my awesome staff. It's great to not only have a staff that you can trust to be good teachers, but also to be good friends and to count on them as people. So thank you to our staff. Thank you to our section leaders, our drum major, our band, our president and officers. But thank you to all these wonderful students who show up to every rehearsal, rain or shine, a hot concert or a cold Halloween parade. They are ready to play. So thank you so much for being here. And we're going to end with a little bit more school spirit. So go ahead, sing along if you know the words, and clap along. And thanks for coming out this afternoon. And we'll see you next time.